And then the big news in boxing, of course, the WBA announced they want Usyk to fight Daniel Dubois and not fight Fury next. Wow. But Robert,
yeah, but isn't there a rule when that's a unification fight?
It oversees, yeah.
So if it's a unification fight, then
it's gonna happen.
I think that's a fight that needs.
I think Usyk beats Fury.
Tough. But Fury's just too big, man. It's just too big, and he knows how to use his fucking body, man. On the fighter, he knows how to use his body.
He showed a shoulder shot, yeah, the dirty behind the head,
he's
all that.
Smart. Maybe not the most talented fighter, man, but he's fucking smart when it comes to.
He's dirty.
Yeah.
And effective. Yeah.
Knowing how to win and get away with it, you know, he's fucking smart. So it's a very tough fight for Usyk, but those fights. Come on, you're making $50 to $100 million, then
you're still winning either way.
You're winning.
Okay, let me ask you this, Robert. You went to camp with Joshua. I thought he looked amazing. I thought if he would have continued what you told him the whole fight, he would have won. But it happens. Now I'm seeing that he's trying out with Virgil Hunter.
Right.
He's trying out with Derek James. Those are great coaches, Robert. No?
Great coaches.
So what? How do you feel? Like, you did your job.
Anthony called me.
Yeah.
He called me. And told me what he was doing, and I respect him, you know.
That's really nice that he did that.
Huh?
Not everybody would do that.
No, he did.
So that's you have to respect him for doing.
I understand, you know, what the way he's seeing things, and honestly, I wish him the best, because even if it was me again, if from what I understand, trying to fight sometime in spring, you know, so that'll be sometime in March or April, and having to go to camp in England, it was gonna be very difficult for me, because I know Jose is gonna be fighting around that time.
Against Regis.
Yes.
Bamos exactly. Has a title fight.
So do you think I'm gonna leave Jose?
Bam.
Again, Jose fighting Reach, which is a fucking very fucking difficult fight, but that's what Jose wants, so that's what we're gonna do. I gotta train my ass up and you know, to have him ready for that fight. You know, Bam is gonna fight around the same time, so I was gonna be in trouble anyway. Hopefully, still, my personal advice, and I told him and all of his team after the fight, right before I left the next day, they all came to, you know, to say goodbye, and I told them all, it doesn't matter who it is, it doesn't matter if it's me again, he needs to change his camps around, he needs to go to the United States, he needs to train in a gym where he's got Joshua Franco, you got Lindolfo Delgado, you got Bam, you got Jose Ramirez. You know, you got young guys that are actually looking up to you, and you cannot say, oh, today I don't want to spar because I'm tired. Oh, I didn't sleep enough last night, so I don't want to train today. Then the young fighters that want to be like you are going to see something. That's not a real champion. You got to give them an example. You got to be better than them so they could be what you are now. That's what Anthony needs. It's not about Derek James doing a better job, Virgil Hunter doing a better job, me doing better than his previous trainer. No, it's about him getting out of his comfort zone and not being the boss, and being doing what he's told to do in a place where he's not going to be comfortable. That's what he needs. That's what he needs. You know, because he is very talented. Very talented. He's got so his power is insane, and he needs to believe in himself. That's it. He can't go by what he sees and on social media, what he reads on reports. He has to be himself and train hard and train, get out of his comfort. I think him coming to the United States anywhere.
If he does camp, let's say with Derek James, for example, he has Charlo in the gym. He has. Earl Spence, Frank Martin. Frank Martin. Oh, that's a tough fight. Exactly. Tough fight.
He's gonna win.
Frank Martin's gonna win. Why?
Yeah. Huh? I think he's gonna win. But you know, but that's what he needs. That's what he needs. Hopefully he does it.
You want to see him win. You want to see him be successful.
He's already got that opportunity. I already know him. But my fucking opportunity was against Usyk, pound for pound, one of the best fighters in the world. That was my fucking opportunity. You know, it doesn't matter who it is. When he comes back, I know they're going to pick him two or three easy fights. So he's going to look good. So that's going to look. That's going to make any trend, whoever he picks. If it's Virgil Hunter or if it's Angel Fernandez, he could just say with Angel. Or he could pick Derrick James. And the opponents he's going to fight, he's going to go out there and knock out. And that's going to make him look good, and that's going to make whoever's training him look good. But it's a big difference. I went in there against Usyk, and we still did better than anybody expected. So that's a big difference.
He was winning the first few rounds, looking good.
That's the difference, you know, that they're not going to go in there against Usyk. They're going to go in there against, you know, easier opponents that he's going to go out and destroy. And, oh, shit, what a difference. Look, he looks so much better. Yeah, but look at the quality of opponents, too. That's a big difference. You know, I think the 4 months that I was over there, I was able to get along very well with all the team.
He has a very nice team. They're very friendly.
And I'm pretty sure everybody in that team would probably prefer coming to us. But at the end, you know, they don't help us. You know, it's going to be Anthony's decision. No, but he did call me. Actually, yesterday or the day before yesterday.
But you know what? I really respect it. I'll tell you why. Because I've seen so many times fighters stay, but try to be stay. I get calls from fighters saying, hey, I don't like my coach. Help me find a new coach. And I'm like, no, tell your coach or don't be sneaky. That's not cool. Because you give 100%. You want them to be honest 100%. So at least he's a nice person. No one could ever say Joshua's not a good person.
Something that that's why I try to stay, keep a relationship with our local trainers, in the area close, because you never know when you're going to need something from me and when they're going to need something from you, or when a fighter from your camp goes to their camp. You have to still keep a relationship, because it's happened to where a point where a fighter comes to me or goes to them, whatever, but comes to me, and the first thing I hear is nothing but negative things about that trainer.
You don't want
to. So I feel like, all right, well, then that's his decision. So, but how do I really know? You know, I think it's best for when that happens, and ever since I've done it, if it's from whichever trainer, I'll give him a call. Hey, you know what? Just let me know.
Your fighter's my job. Sometimes the trainers know something they don't know.
Your fighter came to me, just so you know. You know, I don't know what happened, but he's here now. And, you know, see what he, you know, talk to
how
the
he
trainer,
takes it.
Because
we're
going to continue doing this for many more years. You know, the fighter's career finished and they're done.
I'm going to tell you how I call it, Robert. I say the fighters are like cottage cheese. They have expiration date. Yeah. Trainers are here for the long run. Exactly. They don't expire.
So I also, same thing, you know, I get called. I've got calls. Hey, Robert, just calling
your fighters.
I know this is the fighter you're training or you were training. Well, he came to me. Go for it. I wish you good luck. You know, he's a great person. I've done that already. But I've also had to call them too. You know, but a few years ago, I didn't do it. And it kind of, I was like, you know, because of what I heard. But then I didn't hear it from the trainer. Then when you talk to the trainer and he tells you something different, then you know, there's always two stories.
No, three.
Three.
Her side, his side.
And the truth. So there's always those three stories. So I got to keep that guy. I have to keep that relationship with all my fucking local trainers around here, because we all have to work together. That's
true?
I see it.
So what do you tell Anthony Joshua, Robert?
You know what? There's so many great trainers out there. There's so many great trainers out there. But it could just be Angel himself that could train him if he does it right. If Anthony does things right. Don't think you going to Teddy Atlas or you going to Freddie Roach or you going to...
I would definitely not go to Teddy after Freddie Roach.
I'm just saying,
I know.
Don't think they're gonna make miracles. You have to push yourself to do it, and you have to want it. Because you could do it, you know, he could actually do it himself just with him and Angel Fernando. But he has gotta want to do it. And they have to make that decision, because there's no trainer that's gonna make a miracle. You have to want to do it yourself.
That's true. So there you have it. Stay tuned right here at RGBA, Ellie Secback reporting. What do you think of Teofimo Lopez's fight?
I think the whole boxing world thought Teofimo was gonna maybe have a little bit of hard time for two or three rounds and then
smoke him.
And then smoke him. So since he didn't do that, everybody's saying he lost. I don't think he lost. I think it wasn't also clearly win for Teofimo. It was close. There was a little bit of controversy with those knockdowns that, or the second knockdown that didn't count. So, you know, if they would have counted a knockdown, then the result would have been different. Well, yeah, well, those are ifs. You know, those are ifs. I think he's still, you know, I'm not saying he still did enough because didn't do much either. But neither did Martin. You know,
he runs a lot. He runs.
Ran
that ugly style.
It was a good performance for Teofimo, so everybody thinks he lost. But I honestly think it was all right, you know, for a split or what was it? A split decision?
But you know...
It was called a split, right?
Yeah, but Robert, how you feeling? You getting taller or you have lifts? Go ahead.
Tenía pregunta y decía, al día de hoy, ¿cómo es eso? ¿Cómo que decía? El exacto, no debe ir, no lo voy a contestar.
¿Y te preguntaste?
¿Qué le pongo?
Ya, poner sí, pero...
Pues, ¿tú crees que no?
Robert, the thing is, Teofimo, after the fight, I've heard a lot of fighters say stuff like that, but privately. He said it publicly where, do I still have it? Of course you still have it, but it wasn't the performance you expected. But fighters always doubt themselves
in
this sport.
I think for him, it was a question he asked. He questioned himself at that moment because he didn't perform the way everybody thought he was gonna perform. So he questioned himself, but no, he's young. He still has it. You know, it was just a question he asked whoever was around him, as maybe like almost kind of like excusing himself, you know, because of his performance. He probably thought like it was a really bad performance. But no, it was Martin didn't fight either. Martin was just running, so it was a difficult fight. It was an ugly fight, but I don't think he like clearly lost.
Styles makes fights. So Devin Haney says Kambosos damaged Teofimo. I don't agree.
No, I don't think so. Yeah. I think if Teofimo is damaged, maybe he's damaged himself with personal problems, with, you know, with maybe people around him. I don't know. You know, maybe that's sometimes fighters don't get damaged in the fights. They get damaged outside of the fucking gym. You know, with personal problems, with personal issues with the family, with habits, with, you know, sometimes, you never know, sometimes fighters do drugs that people don't even know.
We've seen it. Yes. No names. We went to visit a fighter. He jumped out the window before we got there. So it happens.
You know, there's a lot of fighters that have issues outside of the ring, you know, and personal problems, family problems, and sometimes they go crazy. Sometimes, and people think, oh, you know, fuck, he's damaged. Boxing, you know, no, it's just life is life, and fucking, they're human beings also, man. They suffer, they go through a lot, they suffer a lot, man. I've always said it, you know, all the fighters, they fight, you know, let's say they're gonna fight in March. Early January, the promoters are already sending all of them to go get their medicals, right?
Yes.
Just
correct.
You know, they
go
do
to get out of the
MRIs,
way, yeah.
All that. So they're healthy there. They're healthy there. They pass all those exams. But then they go into training camp for 2 months. They spar most of the times, three times a week. A lot of fighters get hurt during training. A lot of fighters get concussions during training. A lot of fighters get knocked out during training. But then they already passed their exams. They already passed their exams before. So when they go into the fight, they got some damage already made from training camp. But they don't do those exams the day before the fight because a lot of fights will get canceled. A lot of fights will get canceled. So they don't do it. And fighters get hurt or some fighters get, you know, maybe not even in the ring, but fighters, after they do their exams, after they pass everything, during training camp, family problems every day they go through. Personal things that really affect them.
Or knockdown, concussion, all that broken hand, yes. Broken leg.
All that happens in boxing. But
you still fight because you want to get paid.
Personal problems. You know, guys that are a little mental weak, you know, let's say, you know, a lot of us, they're fucking weak-minded. Sometimes they go through a lot of shit. Wives, girlfriends, brothers, sisters, dads, and moms. Even though the dad and the mom should love you and support you and be there for nothing but love and support, sometimes they're the ones that affect.
Causing it.
They're the ones causing it.
You're right. We see it. We see it.
A lot. We see it a lot, man. I've seen it here in the camp a lot. We've seen it with other fighters a lot where the problem is the dad or the mom. Sometimes.
I remember there's a mom here giving instructions during sparring, and you have to tell her, like, chill. Like,
sometimes it happens where the moms are the ones, you know, they're the ones causing the problem. But the kids are so afraid of the mom and the dad that they won't say anything. They have to live it. They have to live with it, and they have to do it. And boy, they go in the ring, they're not 100%. They can't. There's no way.
It's hard. It's very hard.
100%. No.
That's what people don't realize about fighters. They think having a good stamina, a good skill is good enough, but the mental aspect is very big.
There's so many fighters that could be the best athletes in the world. They could train harder than anybody else, but the minute they finish training, they go into their rooms. They get on social media, they get on their phone, starting making phone calls, starting, you know.
What did they say about me? Is it
a lot of them, yeah. Exactly. A lot of friends don't understand. And right away, oh, did you read what they said about you? Read this? Did you read that? Fuck this, that's not right. But that shit affects the fighter, especially if it's negative, you know.
It's funny
he's done. He shouldn't be fighting anymore. And the fighter reads that, he's gonna start questioning himself.
He's not believing it.
Is that true? Maybe I'm not good enough anymore. Maybe I shouldn't train. Maybe I shouldn't fight anymore. So they go in the ring with a negative mentality. It happens a lot, man.
It's surprised you think that some of the biggest names in the sport are like that, and they shouldn't be. Because you're a superstar. I once had a legend tell me to delete bad comments about him. I can't control the comments, Robert.
See what I mean? See, that's the thing, that's the way it is. And look, and it's boxing. You're actually punching, hurting each other, trying to kill somebody inside the ring. It happens to baseball players, basketball players, soccer players. It happens to just any other sport that they're playing.
Correct.
That they're playing. And it still happens with family problems. How many athletes, you know, whatever sport you want to say, that they're playing. They're competing. They're playing. They're not fighting like boxing.
Correct.
How many other sports, how many stories have you heard on they make movies or specials on HBO about the dad causing the problem, the dad pushing the son because that's my money. You're gonna make me rich.
Yeah.
How many times have we seen that? In other sports that are playing, you know, they go out and play tennis. They go out and play baseball. They go out and play basketball. And they still have those problems that cause a lot of fucking mental problems to the athlete. Imagine boxing.
You remember that?
If you have a dad that's fucking making you fucking fight, you fucking better fucking fight. You better fucking win because I made you and fucking you're doing this for me. You know, and then he has to go and fucking punch somebody and somebody has to punch him. Even worse, bro.
Do you remember that movie He Got Game with Ray Allen and Denzel Washington?
Right.
But the dad came and he pushed it, like, do it for me, I made you.
Dads like that in boxing. There's dads like that. So in other sports, at least they're fucking game. In fucking boxing, they're punching their ass off in the head.
And there's no guarantee for the money or anything. It's like, it's sad, but we've seen tragedies like the Pritchard Cologne. We don't know exactly like what caused it, but
yeah, you know what? And then you also see the it could also be a tragedy, you know, maybe not but where the fighter did everything that the dad wanted him to do and became what he wanted, the guy wanted, but then at the end he was never happy. The fighter or the athlete was never happy, never lived a life, never
couldn't enjoy himself.
Yeah, and then at the end you know, they made the dad rich, but they don't even talk to him anymore.
I've seen that many times. I've seen that.
Many times. It happens, Ellie.
Yeah.
It's fucking life. It happens. Huh? What?
Sacrifice.
You have to give up a lot of shit, yeah.
No, that's true, but I know what you're saying. Like, money's not everything. That's why I kind of respect Ryan Garcia's dad, because he's like, he told me, my son comes first. Not the money, not everything. I let other people coach him, so I don't have to get to where you're saying, where my son will hate me so much and not talk to me, because my relationship with him is... But Ryan's dad gets it, and he's like, you know what? I want someone else to coach him, and he's always going to be my son.
It does happen, man.
Is that? I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.